I want to buy a house for $300,000, but I only want my payment to be $1,200. Can I pull that off? More often than not, the answer to that question is no. And then I get asked, well, why is that? And the answer to that question is something called math. It breaks down pretty simply when we look at your mortgage payment. Number one, you have your principal and interest. That's the part that actually pays the loan. Number two, you have homeowner's insurance. That's just like car insurance. So when you go buy your car and you need to put insurance on it, your house is no different. Call Allstate, Farmers, Liberty Mutual, whatever company you want to use, but your home has to be insured if you got a lien on it. The third thing is property taxes. Property taxes are determined by the county or the state that you live in. And the fourth thing is that not everybody has, but most people do, is mortgage insurance. So how do those pieces fit together? Well, I'm here to tell you. Number one is mortgage insurance. Mortgage insurance is determined by the type of loan that you get, your down payment, and your credit score, okay? So once you've talked to a lender and they know your credit score, they know how much money you're able to put down, and they know what type of loan you're gonna get, your mortgage insurance is pretty much determined, which means that you really can't affect that number in any way other than by putting more money down, improving your credit score, or changing your loan program. And even in those cases, it's not gonna change very much. The second component of this is your property taxes. So this is the piece that actually moves the most. This is the piece that will change depending on what house you're looking at. But once you pick a house, the property taxes are predetermined. The county determines this, the state determines this, the jurisdiction in which you're living, depending on the city, the municipality, if you got colleges, schools, or whatever in your area, that's what's gonna determine your property tax. But once you pick the house that you wanna buy, that number is gonna be determined already for you. So there's really nothing that you can do to affect that number. So when you're looking at two houses, you literally can have one house right next door to the next, and they can have the exact same square footage built in the exact same year, but have different property taxes. Why is that? Well, depending on the state that you live in, a lot of times the county that sets the value of your house can't raise that value on any given year more than a certain percentage, depending again on the state. I live in Texas, as you can obviously see, and in Texas, it used to be 10%. You couldn't raise the property value any more than 10%. They've recently changed it down to 3.5%, but that just means that if you live in your house and it's your homestead, that the county's not gonna raise your value up dramatically every year to have your taxes skyrocket. However, once you buy the house, the county can then come in and change that value of your home to whatever level they want. So if you buy your house for $300,000, but on the tax rolls, it's listed at 200. Well, good news is for the first couple of years, your taxes are gonna be pretty low. But odds are within about 12 to 18 months, that tax rate is gonna go up. The tax value, I should say, is going to go up because the county then goes in once the property changes hands and they can set that value to whatever level they want. Does the tax value mean what your house value is? The answer to that is no. The market determines that. You'll get an appraisal when you buy a home that determines what the actual market value of your home is, but the value on the tax records is something that's set by the county or by the state. So when you're looking at property taxes, they vary quite a bit from home to home, depending on how long the person's lived there, if they fight their property taxes every year, or what the circumstances are. So that is a number, again, that you can impact, but once you pick the house and once you select where you want to live, that number's not going to change. The third component of your payment is your homeowner's insurance. Homeowner's insurance you can get from any company you want. Allstate, Farmers, Liberty Mutual, whatever company you choose, you get to select the vendor for that. But depending on the purchase price for the house, if it's $200,000, if it's $250,000, if it's $300,000, your homeowner's insurance is gonna be pretty close to the same. Just as a general reference, I would say as a lending professional, if your home is between $200,000 and $350,000, odds are your homeowner's insurance policy is gonna be about $200 a month. It could be $185, it could be $215, but it's gonna be somewhere in that range. So you can affect that number depending on which vendor you choose to be your insurance provider, but at the end of the day, the separation between the payments isn't as significant as you might think. So you might be able to affect that number, but not too dramatically. Fourth component, which is the most important, is your principal and interest. This is the portion that actually pays the loan. So when you look at your principal and interest payment on your mortgage statement, it consists of two things, principal and interest. The principal is the piece that you pay down on the loan every month to make your loan balance less. The interest is the amount that you're paying basically to borrow the loan, to borrow the money. So when you look at what impacts those numbers, that's two things. Number one, it's your down payment. How much money are you putting down? Are you putting down the minimum? Are you putting down 20%? Are you putting down 25%, 10%? What's that number? The second component is the interest rate. What is the rate that you got for that loan and how much does that impact that payment? Well, when you talk about the down payment, as a general rule of thumb right now, I personally recommend people either put down the minimum or 20%. Why is that? Well, on any standard loan right now, for every $10,000 that you put down that doesn't get you to 20%, your payment only changes by about $50 a month. Well, why is that? Well, when you look at a mortgage loan that's spread out over 30 years at a very low interest rate, somewhere between 2, 3, and 4%, and you take that and you change that principal balance by $10,000 over that period of time, it doesn't move the needle enough to be able to have a significant impact. It's going to change the number, but it's not going to change it as much as you think. The second portion of that is your interest rate. Well, how does the interest rate affect it? Well, again, generally speaking, interest rates move in percentages of 1/8 of a point. So 3%, 3.125, 3.25, on a scale up to 4 or 5 or whatever level you get to. Within that range, for every 1/8 of a point, when you're looking at a $200,000 loan, your payment's only going to change about 15 bucks a month. So that means if you lock in your rate at 3.125, but the market adjusts, and for some reason you could have got a lower rate and you just happened to miss out on it, it just means you missed out on 15 bucks a month, okay? So it doesn't move the needle, again, as much as people think it does. So once we know what your down payment is, if you're putting down 5% or 3% or 20%, and we know what your interest rate is, if it's 3% or 2.875 or 3.125, well then at that point, your principal and interest is pretty much set. And again, if you want to put down more money, you can, but for every $10,000, it's only going to change your payment about 50 bucks. So when we look at all four components of your mortgage payment, the principal and interest, the homeowner's insurance, the property taxes, and the mortgage insurance, what of those components can we actually affect? Well, once we know your down payment, credit score, and your loan program, we can't change your mortgage insurance. Once we know what your property taxes are and you pick the house that you want to live in, we can't change your property taxes. Can we change your homeowner's insurance? Yes, we can, but we can only adjust that number maybe 10 or 15 or 20 bucks in either direction. And then on your principal and interest, once we know your down payment and your interest rate, that number's not gonna change dramatically. So when someone says, hey Mike, how can I take that $1,800 payment and make it $1,200? The answer is you can't. The only way to do that is to buy a lesser house, because once we know what you're putting down and what type of loan you're doing and what your credit score is, then that payment is what it is. And there's not a whole lot you can do to impact it unless you have a significant amount of cash. So if you want to take your $1,800 payment and bring it down to $1,200, you need to find another house. And that's just math. So if you have any questions or anything else you'd like to find out, please drop a comment below. Like and share this. I really appreciate it. And I hope you have a great day. Thanks a lot and be good humans. Talk to you soon.